Now we need to create a profile of the existing ground along our proposed alignment. We also need to create a proposed vertical alignment for our roadway. To start, we will go to the Home tab. Find the Profile pull-down menu and click on that. Select Create a Surface Profile. This will be a profile of the proposed roadway. We want to display the existing surface. And we will create a profile from the start to the end of the project. The rest of the default settings are usually good, so we can just click Add. That adds this information into the profile list. Next, select the Draw in Profile View button. This takes us to the dialog box where we can enter in specifics about our profile. The profile view name can be Proposed Roadway. In the description, we can remind ourselves that we are designing a 2-lane rural road. Hit Next. Here it confirms that we will be working from the starting to the ending stations, which is what we wanted, so click Next. The default view height settings are fine. We have an option over here of splitting the profile view. You can experiment with this option. Click Next. The defaults for the display options are typical. Next. The data bands are labeling features and how the profile is being created. We will accept these defaults as well. Next. Options for hatching can be useful. But for now, we will leave it blank. Hit Create Profile View. Now notice that it's asking us to select the profile view origin. We will work from left to right placing the profile. So we'll click on a place for the origin. The profile will be created to the right and upward of the origin. And here the profile appears. It's very cluttered and not very usable right now. Find a place along the profile and click on it to select the entire profile. Let's right-click to display a flyout menu, and we want Edit Profile View Style. Starting at the Information tab, we have the general information on how we set up the profile. Under the Graph tab, we want to change the vertical exaggeration factor. Ten is very drastic and can make it hard to estimate how steep things really are. Let's change the vertical exaggeration factor to 2. The horizontal scale being 500 forces the vertical scale to be 250, which is not common. We may change this later. Under the Grid tab, we can change how the grids are displayed. We will not change anything in the Titles tab. The horizontal axis does require some change. The major tick marks and lines at 100-foot intervals are what's making the profile so busy. We'll set our major interval to 1,000, the same as our stationing, and the minor interval can be at 500. The vertical axis is very busy as well. Let's change the major interval to 200 and the minor tick to 100. Under the Display tab, we can identify which layers are associated with this image. We can also control the layers from here. We'll hit Apply and say OK. Now we can see the changes we made to the alignment and its labeling. Zooming in, we can see that there are labels at the top and at the side that need editing as well. First, let's adjust our scale to 1 inch equals 1,000. Now we can see that the text size has increased. Click on the profile and right-click. Select Edit Profile View Styles. Let's start with the Graph tab. With the exaggeration factor set at 2, there's a better vertical scale. We'll keep our grid settings. When we changed the labels for the horizontal axis, we changed only the settings on the bottom labeling. Let's click the top and set the major and minor ticks to 1,000 and 500 respectively. And let's update the vertical axis the same way, setting the right side to match the left, with major ticks at 200 and minor ones at 100. Let's click Apply, and we can see that our changes took effect, so it's looking better. We'll click OK. Now let's look at some of the options for settings on the profile. Select the profile and right-click. First, let's look at Profile View Properties. The Information tab holds the name and general information about the alignment. The style may be left at the default. The Stations tab reminds us that we have a profile running from the start to the end of the project. The Elevation tab provides us with the range of elevations on the profile. We also have the option to split this profile if we choose. The Profiles tab provides us with the profile settings and specifications. The Bands tab includes the labeling features of the profile. The hatch options might be useful after we've created a proposed alignment. We can press cancel because nothing was changed. Now we are ready to design our proposed vertical alignment.